Happy New Year to all of YouTube. This is Sean Bradley giving you all a review of Silence, the new film co-written, co-produced and directed by one of my favourite filmmakers and one of cinema's greats, Mr. Martin Scorsese.
The plot follows fathers Sebastián Rodríguez and Francisco Garupe, played by Andrew Garfield and Adam Driver, two Jesuit priests who travel from Portugal to Japan to not only spread the word of the gospel and bring Christianity to the country, but to locate their mentor, Father Cristóvão Ferreira, played by Liam Neeson, who has committed apostasy after being tortured into denouncing his Christian faith. Whilst in Japan, Rodriguez and Garupe face violence and persecution by the Japanese authorities that try to wipe out Christianity and force everybody into converting to Buddhism. This makes Father Rodriguez question his faith and everything that he stands for.
It has taken Martin Scorsese over 25 years to finally get this film to the big screen. It was a passion project that he was developing for a long time, since 1990, 2 years after his other religion-based film, 1988's
The Last Temptation of Christ, which also dealt with the themes of religious persecution.
Scorsese's film marks the third adaptation of
Shusaku Endo's 1966 novel of the same name, as it was first adapted in 1971 as a Japanese production by filmmaker Masahiro Shinoda, under the worldwide title of Silence, but was released in its native country of Japan as Chinmoku, with David Lampson and Don Kenny in the lead roles of the two priests, and was readapted in 1996 by Portuguese filmmaker João Mário Grilo as The Eyes of Asia, despite the latter not crediting the source novel in its Wikipedia and IMDb pages.
Shusaku Endo was inspired to write the novel after seeing
Federico Fellini's 1954 film La Strada. It inspired him to conceive the story, including the supporting character of Kichijiro.
This story was based on historical facts.
Father Ferreira was an actual historical figure. Endo had based the main protagonist of Sebastián Rodríguez on an Italian priest called Giuseppe Ciara, who he had renamed Sebastián Rodrogo, or in the English translation, Rodriguez, and had changed his nationality from Italian to Portuguese.
Scorsese kept putting off making this film for so long, and has talked about adapting the novel since the 1980s.
In fact, it's been so long that many reprints of the book include a foreword at the beginning penned by Scorsese himself. Actors Daniel Day-Lewis, Gael Garcia Bernal, and Benicio del Toro were attached to play the three leads, but dropped out due to the repeated delays in the film's development. In 1990, Scorsese had signed a written agreement to Setchigori Pictures that he will direct the film, intending for it to be his next feature after 1997's Kundun. Instead, he directed a series of features including Bringing Out the Dead and Gangs of New York, which was also co-written by Jay Cox, who had collaborated with Scorsese on an early draft of the script for Silence. Scorsese intended for Silence to be filmed next. However, due to an unsuccessful search for funding for this film, he instead made The Aviator. After that, he alleged to Setchigori Pictures that Silence would be his next film. But then he made The Departed, which won Best Picture at the 79th Academy Awards and won Scorsese the Academy Award for Best Director. He would also make Shutter Island and Hugo, agreeing to pay various fees after each feature prior to Silence. In 2012, Setchigori Pictures had enough and sued Scorsese and his production company, Sicilia, for two counts of breach of contract after Scorsese had agreed to direct 2013's The Wolf of Wall Street as his next film. So, the film was caught in limbo until January 17th, 2014, when both sides came to a mutual agreement in a legal settlement, thus pulling silence out of development hell.
Martin Scorsese is one of my favourite filmmakers, and he has directed some of the greatest films in history. I've seen most of his films, including Mean Streets, Taxi Driver, Raging Bull, and Goodfellas,
which, by the way, was recently re-released by the BFI as part of the Martin Scorsese season.
He directs this film wonderfully, with his usual tropes of narration serving as the inner monologue of the characters, the closing credits being displayed in still form, and the brutal violence. And boy, is this film brutal. The film had a very sadistic depiction of persecution.
The film begins with Father Ferreira watching his fellow Christians tied to a cross and scalded with hot water, just as he is about to face the exact same punishment.
The scenes where the characters are being forced by the Japanese inquisitors to renounce their Christianity is very brutal in some scenes, including a beheading scene that I had both expected, but not expected as I was unsure of the method of execution. However, in other scenes, it is heartbreaking and just nearly brought a tear to my eye. The other scenes where the villagers are being burned and drowned.
There's a scene where a villager is tied to a cross like a crucifixion, forced to endure the waves crashing onto him. He is praying for the souls of the two villagers who are on the verge of dying.
This film is 2 hours and 41 minutes long. Though the film is mostly harrowing and entertaining, there are times when you can feel the pace a bit. The art direction is wonderful, including some shots that are enclosed in fog,
making it mysterious as to what is actually happening.
Cinematography is amazing. It was done by
Rodrigo Prieto, who had previously photographed Scorsese's previous film, The Wolf of Wall Street,
making the country of Japan look both beautiful, even in the more macabre scenes of the film. It is up there with the best of 2016, including
Seamus McGarvey's cinematography for Nocturnal Animals.
The performances in this film are top-notch. Andrew Garfield is brilliant in this film, conveying a range of many different emotions.
The character of Father Rodriguez is a man of faith, and there are scenes in which he sees the face of Jesus Christ that make him feel better.
Over the course of the film, his faith in God begins to deteriorate. He is forced to watch as other innocent people are brutally slaughtered, and he is blamed for their suffering. Adam Driver,
known for portraying the role of Kylo Ren in Star Wars The Force Awakens,
does some good acting in the film.
He looks the part of a Portuguese priest. Him and Andrew Garfield do have some good chemistry together, with him being the realist to Garfield's optimist.
But Liam Neeson, he's a good actor except for the accent. In his opening voiceover, he sounded a little British, but towards the end of the film, he speaks in his native Northern Irish accent.
Liam Neeson has always had a problem with his accent when it comes down to his modern roles. He does not have a lot of screen time in this film, but he does good with his role.
The supporting cast are an ensemble of brilliance. I am not going to list any of these people because I do not want to butcher their names. I am going to talk about the actors who had played supporting characters, like the character of
Makichi, who is a hidden Christian that is thankful for the two priests, but still holds on to his faith, even when he is being persecuted for his beliefs. The actors who played the Japanese authorities, including the Inquisitor, did very well in their performances. You made me hate every single one of you murdering lot.
So in conclusion, Silence is one of Martin Scorsese's best, with excellent cinematography, complex framing of the shots, harrowing performances, including an Oscar-worthy performance from Andrew Garfield. I look forward to what Scorsese does next,
which will be an adaptation of Eric Larson's The Devil in the White City, starring Leonardo DiCaprio.
I give this film a 9 out of 10. This is Sean Bradley, signing out. I'll see you later. Bye.